Everybody knows what an oak tree is, but you don't necessarily associate oaks with the mountains. Most people are thinking of conifers, you know, or pines and that sort of thing. And so when they come to Yosemite Valley, they quickly realize and identify a tree that is familiar.
Of course, this tree is beautiful, and most people are quite content with just the beautiful tree, but there's these other levels. This tree has been vitally important to the wildlife and an integral part of the human history here.
So this guy, I'm estimating, is probably about 5 feet in diameter near the base, and that would correlate to an age of about 250 to 300 years old. Unlike conifers, they change throughout the season, whereas conifers are green throughout the year. Oaks, like the black oak, are deciduous, so they lose their leaves in the winter. They look dead in the winter, but they're actually still alive.
Springtime comes around, the leaves start to unfurl, and those leaves are coated with little tiny red hairs. And as that leaf gets bigger, those red hairs start to disappear.
The pendulant catkins are the clusters of male flowers that appear when the leaves first come out in the springtime. And they pollinate the female flowers on different trees. And the female flowers are really inconspicuous, small green flowers that aren't normally seen by visitors.
Summertime, the leaves have expanded and it's trying to soak up as much sun as it can. Those flowers that would have been pollinated in the spring are now starting to turn into acorns. These oak woodlands are some of the most diverse habitats in all of California. And the reason for that diversity is the acorn. It's the acorn that's attracting the wildlife. Black bear, mule deer, California ground squirrel, and probably the most obvious, the acorn woodpecker.
So the acorn woodpeckers collect black oak acorns and other acorns, and a lot of times they tend to cache them in certain trees, so you'll find hundreds to thousands of these acorns in holes that they drill into the tree. They're really quite remarkable if you find one.
Not only is the acorn important to the wildlife, but you know, human history here. We have an extensive human history, and a large portion of their diet was tied to these black oak acorns.
This tree is the one that was giving off all the acorns. See, it's a good one. And let's see, here's another one here. And there. Well, the black oak was very important to the first people, the Awanichi people, and to the Yosemite Indians, and to Southern Sierra Miwok and Mono Lake Paiute people. They're all one brand of Indians. My story starts with acorn when I came into the valley here a good number of years ago, and I was introduced to the Indian people at the Indian village, and of course intermarried there, and then I learned a lot of story about the acorn from my husband's grandmother, Lucy Tellis. She said that you have to let the acorns dry. It has to dry thoroughly. And when it dries, she says, then you can crack it open. Okay, there. Do you hear that snap? See, whatever snaps like that, it tells you it's going to be a good acorn. Then we can peel it open like this. And I always say, be good, acorn, be good. So you're not guaranteed you're going to have a good acorn every time you crack it, you know, because, you know, it's just only natural that you'll find have some that don't that aren't good. I was newly married and in the village, and I could hear this pounding, you know, pounding, 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 and I was wondering what that was. So I came out of the house and I went over to where Lucy Tellis's house was, and she was sitting out there like I'm sitting here with a pounding rung. She was pounding her acorns. You'll be surprised how quick you can get your flower when you do this way. See, some of it's already turning into flower down there. See the flower?
Some of my favorite things in this park are the more subtly beautiful things that you might not notice right off, but once you get tuned into that, you become a big fan for the rest of your life.
To me, the black oak tree is the most beautiful, beautiful tree because of the food that it gives to the people. I like trees anyway, you know. Black oak is very special.